Our first paper will be given by Nafeesa, Haji from the University of Exeter, and her title, unless it's changed, is Intertextuality as Strategies of Avoiding Political and Social Censorship in the Kurdish Short Story in Iraqi Kurdistan after 1990.
So, as I say, my topic is intertextuality in strategy, as a strategy of avoiding censorship in my short story in Iraq Kurdistan after 1991. So, first time I will give you a short introduction and then my argument, and then I will give you an examples from my short story that I'm presenting in this paper, and lastly, a very short conclusion. So, I'm dealing with a period which is after 1991. So in Iraq, Kurdistan, which the year of the Kurdish uprising against the Ba'athist regime, and since that everything has been changed because the Kurdish in this area get autonomy. So the literature and everything has changed. So the literature before this period was just like a tool for resistance and defense of Kurdish rights. However, after that, the literature became a part of a bigger project to modernize the Kurdish society. So, and even after this period, the Kurdish get, especially the writers, get an enormous right for expression. However, the society as a ethical and religious one, there's still censorship in the society. So, and especially this kind of getting the new principles of modernism happened kind of a conflict with the society, the normal principle of the society. So. And the way of the Kurdish. Also, there's many things happened after this period, such as internal war, changed the writers' thought and the way, their way of writing or presenting their text. So my argument here is the main argument. So I put forward that Kurmanji authors have reimagined and transposed pre-existing literary and non-literary texts for new purposes. The strategy of intertextuality enabled them to raise indirectly the local, social, and religious and political issues, because through this they have been able to present predicted texts that can be always understood in a variety of ways. So, and I'm arguing that both texts presenting the idea of savior in these two texts that I'm presenting here. And for my analysis of the text, I depend on the transposition, this concept of transposition from of Kristeva. So my two short stories that I have analyzed, first one is Maramid by Yunus Ahmed. And I'm arguing that there is a religious intertextuality, and Ahmed has transposed many pre-existing religious signifying practices and destroyed them to suit his purposes of his short story, which is presenting the idea of savior. So the savior in his short story is a doctor who attempts to rescue people from illness and death. During his journey, he will face many kinds of conflicts. There is a conflict between himself and the other side of, as a human being, there is always two sides in our side, which the side you try to do the good, and the other side that forbidden you to go further, and because there is maybe, in this short story, there is many dangers in his way. So. And also, as he's presenting the idea from the religion and destroying them for his purposes, there will be the savior in this short story is a doctor who his source is a science. So there will be conflict between the science and the religion. In his journey for doing good, for helping people and saving them from illness and death, he will face this kind of conflict. And first, he will go to two missions. He will do two missions in his journey. The first one is helping people who she's giving birth. And his internal struggle will begin when he starts thinking about whether to follow, because he will get a call from this person, this woman, and so he will just thinking, because there's many dangers in the way, there's a stormy atmosphere, so he just will be in this conflict, shall I go or not, just ignore his asking for help. So at the end he will act as a savior and he will decide to go. So in this mission, the writer employs and transforms a number of religious pre-existing signifying practices to present the characters in conflict. First one is when the doctor arrives at the destination during a powerful storm, he realizes he needs to cross flooded river to get a young woman about to give birth in a small hut, who asked for his help. During the process of giving birth, he discovered that, that's the first idea from the religion, he will discover that she's virgin. Hence, there is an allusion here to a virgin mother, for it's well known in the Christianity, and also it can be found in Zoroastrianism. And I think the writer has used the idea from the Zoroastrianism, not from the Christianity, because there's many signs in the text make me think that. So, and the second religious pre-existing practices that the writer have been employed is the idea of savior and sacrifice. After the birth of the baby, he is presented by the mother as a sacrifice to the flooded river, to save the doctor, so the doctor can cross the flooded river. And this is unlike with the religious story. The main savior is not the baby who born. Although his role is important, as without him the doctor cannot continue his work. It is the doctor who is taking the idea of he's the savior for the people in this short story. So the storm and flooded could represent evil in the form of destruction or war, with manifest themselves as a barrier goodness. Consequently, goodness needs sacrifice in order to face down evil, and hence continue offering the baby to the flooded river would appear to be a symbol of this sacrifices. The water level of the river subsides after the sacrifice has been made, and so the doctor attempts to traverse it. The water has destroyed the bridge over the river. So, and the only a very thin thread which connects both sides of remain of it. So, in this idea of the thin bridge, also he's taking from the religion, especially from even it is in the Islam as well. But I think he's taking from the Zoroastrianism, that there's a jivat bridge which every people after. In the other world, they have to, as a judgment, they have to cross this bridge. So when the doctor will be able to really cross this bridge, that means the transfer of the signs, or as a doctor, the savior, and continue his mission for doing the right for people. So the character, he successfully crossed the bridge. This refers to the triumph, as I saw, the triumph of the good over the evil side within him, which gulfness his mission to save the people and hence save them. The another religious pre-existence signifying practices that has been transposed by Ahmed in his appearance. I think the most important that the present idea of the writer in this short story is that when the doctor be at the center of the bridge, there will appear a whale for him. And this idea of appearing a whale, we can link it to the idea of the Jonah or Yunus, Prophet Jonah or Yunus, even in the Bible or in the Quran as well. But the difference here is that in the origin story, the whale, the God, he's sending the whale because when the God sent Prophet Jonah or Yunus to the city of Nineveh, he left the mission. He didn't continue his mission because the people didn't listen to him, or just a few of them listened to him. So the God sent whale to keep Yunus or the Jonah in his stomach as a punishment for him. Whereas the idea has been transposed by writer in this short story, that the whale appeared for the doctor, so he tried to convince him to didn't continue his journey for goodness. So that's why I'm saying that the writer in this short story, he's trying to say the right way to do good is the science, whereas he presenting the religion as a barrier or there's conflict. So and that's why I'm saying in such society, Eastern society, he cannot say this in direct way. So the intertextuality becomes a strategy for avoiding the society censorship. So and even in his next mission, he's going to he will find a man who's dead, and then they will just waiting his grave to be ready, so they bury him. Whereas he will ask the people to let him to check, because he's a doctor, to check the people, so it's really dead or not. And the people will say it's unrespect of death or unrespect of religion. They will not let him. Whereas when he assists to doing that, and the wife of the man, she will say, let him to check the my husband. When he do that, he will discover that the man is alive. And that's another sign from the text, that the transfer of the signs he's presented in his short story. Actually the short story is very long, but I cannot give you all examples. Just I gave these examples as define my. So the second short story is conflict between the writer and the politic. So it's really very important. in the second short story, which is Sarhatya Bajalekish Birkiri, is the tale of the tale of Forgotten City. He's employing the idea from heritage or from the writer employed a part of a long folklore tale called Mirza Muhammad. A summary of this part is that Mirza Muhammad, during his journey, arrived in the underworld with he will be guest of elderly women. When he requires some water from the woman, she tells him a story about the city, that there's a giant who controlling the only spring of the city, and he just a year he will let people access to the water, and this is when they present a girl as a sacrifice. This idea have been transposed and destroyed by the writer. So the writer is saying that the savior, Mirza Muhammad, is the savior in the short story. In the tale folklore, Mirza Muhammad will come to rescue the girl by killing the giant, and the city, rescue the city all. But in the short story, which he's doing, he's destroying this idea, because the savior, which is Mirza Muhammad, will never appear, and the the short story presenting that there's a girl, she will be presented to the giant, the which is a daughter of the ruler, whereas just they told people that is a daughter of the ruler. So they think that Mirza Muhammad is in the city and he will come to rescue the girl. But Mirza Muhammad actually cooperating with the ruler and with the giant. So he's facing this idea of the he's destroying this idea of the savior because he's portraying the people. So taking the time that this short story has been written, which is after 1991. Which is in 1997, the writer trying to say because after the Kurdish parties in Iraq, Kurdistan was they just like a savior. it's really.
Can you just maybe skip to the conclusion?
Okay. So the conclusion is that
I don't mean to be strict, but it's one of those things where at a conference this will happen to you. So it's good practice.
The idea is that he's presenting, criticizing that in one short story he's criticizing the idea, religious one. In the second one he's criticizing the politicians in Kurdistan. So he cannot present this idea directly. So he's using intertextuality as a strategy for avoiding censorship. The religion one, the political one, or the social one.
Great. Thank you very much.